Everyone, this is Cliff. So for this next episode, we are going to be shrinking the sides of the conveyor to more or less match the sprocket. There's going to be a little bit of excess. We're going to take care of that by building in a takeaway. Okay? Let's open up our assembly. Here. So, seven half inch, because we had them. 80-20. Let me check the part number. Okay, so the outside diameter is 6.06. So what we'll do, we'll go with 7. We'll start with that. We can change it later if we need to. Try this again. So I said 7, and we're at 11 7/8. And we'll just round to 5, so that's an even number. And we left ourselves a little bit of room in the tolerances. Okay. I'm going to also assign rebuild. Okay, Control B. We're actually going to make this we're going to change the relationship on this. Construction line. and I'll remember this better over time. So 7, control B. That was the left hand. I'm going to do the right hand. I still haven't put the holes in yet because I'm going to locate it off the other one, and I'll just save just a little bit of time. Okay, so that looks pretty good. What we're gonna do now is put a little bit of lead-in in. So the chain's gonna be running this way, so we don't need a lead-in right there. Actually, wait. I lied, we do need a lead in there. We'll do up to vertex on this one. That's the vertex. So now what we're going to do Isti. So what I should have done. Edit the sketch. Okay, so another tool I like to use a lot is trim. So this is going to go back to 6.5 inches. Like it may be too much. We'll do 8 degrees and we can change this later. Basically, we want the lead in to looks like we may need to adjust that a little bit, but for right now, it's okay. Okay. Thank you for watching.